She is the joint director of CLAB. Before she begins, I'd like to tell you that why we are calling the paper presentation as a competition, it is to ensure that the best will come out of the speaker and also to encourage the spirit and sportsmanship. So it is not that, I mean, Priyanka is a very senior person from CIDAC and some other speaker is really someone who is at the early stages of the career. So there may not be some match to find the best best speaker or best paper out of this, but it is just to make sure that we still have a sportsmanship in ourselves. That is the only reason.
Thank you very much for a kind introduction. And good afternoon, all of you. I am Priyanka, as mentioned. And very short, I think I have 7 minutes of time.
10 minutes.
10 minutes.
I'll cover it.
So I'm going to tell you about a story of evaluating an automatic text visualization system. So first thing first, what is text visualization? Along with the outline of the presentation. So we have been to Wix website many a time. So we have seen this logo. So what this depicts? This logo. Is a speaker? Is it? Yeah. This is?
Audience.
Volunteer. Collaboration and partnership, panel discussion. So what I want to say means we can find this information, we could interpret this information without having a language, a word or letters behind this. So this is what is called a cognition. Cognition is a process of mental information which is grasped by the brain based on a prior experience or perspective. And it is visual cognition when it comes in a form of visual processing. So this is somewhat related to my topic, maybe a bit different, but I can go ahead with my topic. So when we're talking about cognition, how it works. So we have a brain and we have the person who has left brain dominating persons. So right dominating brain person, how they perceive the information and scenario based on their pictorial representation, they process this information very fast and quickly. The person who is having left brain dominating, they process the information which is in linguistic form like language, words and alphabets. But the problem with linguistic representation is that it would require to have a linguistic knowledge, at least the knowledge of script behind the information which is presented into the manual. So this is the problem which I found it to be worked with being in artificial intelligence group for last 19 years. So I'm working with NLP most of the time. So this is the thing, problem statement I can proceed with. So I came out with a solution like automatic text visualization. So what is this? It's a computational process of understanding the text, textual information and transforming into a form of visual representation. That would be a scene, image, picture, a 3D scene or virtual reality. Means this is a process of text to scene conversion. And it is a newer interdisciplinary research area which consists of natural language processing, knowledge engineering, computer graphics and cognitive computing, etc. Uses of this application is one or foremost is the language learning, because there are a problem in some people, means the person who is having learning disability, mainly for reading disability, the difficulty is called dyslexia. The person who is having dyslexia is found difficulty in reading the language text. So for those person, that when the language is difficult to read, they can interpret the information by pictorial form, like in first scene the color, shape, size, order, sequence can be interpreted well by a person who is having reading difficulty, in particular the attribute reference. And the second picture is showing about the understanding directions. So this is the pictures has been taken from Versailles. I'll go a bit faster. Versailles, the popular application available only for language English. It is useful for localization and summarization. And when Atara sentence in Hindi, Diwali par hum aarti karte hain. So when if we go for a textual translation, we can translate it ki we worship on Diwali. But when this textual translation, when it is interpreting into the another side of globe, so it cannot take all the information which is available into the input. So visual translation is the form can be used for a cultural translation. It's a complete information, complete transformation of information, adequate information translation. It has higher bandwidth, visualization. So it can be, it can be named. It is being used for symbols like traffic signals and other map symbols and other symbols, and it is used for summarization. This is the world of data obesity. Enormous data is available around the globe, so the information which is available in a paragraph form, instead of reading a complete paragraph in right section of this PPT, we can summarize it into form of picture, and which can be presented well in a, it can be grasped in a glimpse of a view. Also, it is useful in knowledge sharing, because being in multilingual country like India, so we have a domination of many languages across the nation, and it is useful for cross language barrier also. So here I comes with the objective, that is a Preksha. We have developed Preksha. It is automatic text visualization system, and this is the only language system which is working for English language Hindi, and it is extended for other Indian languages. The specific beauty behind Preksha, it is morphological rich, and free word order language can be taken by this feature. So the design of Preksha, I've said that this is extendable for other Indian languages, and in this session we are going to talk about the ATV systems and the proposed subjective evaluation methodology. The components are consist of language comprehension main and the visual representation, two part. So I would like to share one of the scene generated by out of Preksha. The input text which has given: conference table for Safed laptop, silver laptop, CD hai, blah blah blah. So all those stuff when it is given to the system Preksha, the scene generated out of the Preksha is this. So this is the only system which is available which works with language Hindi, and it is able to understand a good quality of information and represent it in a visualized form. So looking into the existing work of existing scenario for other European work, it is found that it is not very these applications which are available across the globe are not very suitable for real life applications. So there was a need felt for having an evaluation methodology which can be evaluate they can check the quality of the existing systems for their what real time applicability in terms of fidelity, intelligibility and complexity. But as the ATV systems are difficult to build, along with this it is more difficult to evaluate. Why? Because it is not like text to text translation. It is unlike machine translation, where the translation output is in terms of sequence of some words, and we can map the words and the sequence of words and contextual information we can interpret. It's not like this, because the output is a scene. We cannot provide the reference, because there are infinite possibility to have or references of a particular input text. Given input text, you can have a thousands of pictures related to it. So you cannot provide a reference for cross evaluation. If given some 2, 3, 4, 5 reference, you cannot compare those reference of human evaluated with a system generated output, because the comparison, again, it requires technology, and that we are not in that shape right now. So we are talking about much ahead time, which is going to come after 10 years. So these are the challenges. Apart from this, given a scene, if we ask you to interpret the information which is provided into the generated scene, so given this scene, again, it's difficult for you to provide the action against it. You cannot say whether they are standing, they are thinking, they are dreaming, they are waiting, they are observing. Means there are infinite number of possible combinations. So in this way, why there are challenges, because there are n number of input combinations with semantics of the language and n number of visual representation. So there are many to many relations. So it's difficult to evaluate a scene generated out of a textual information because of any computational process. So what we came across, we propose a evaluation plan. We are using a subjective evaluation methodology. We have prepared some tense test set, and we are generating a scene out of it. So 10 set and generated 10 set scene test suit, and we have provided it for a Google online survey. We have prepared a survey, and we came across with a survey. So the parameter which we have evaluated are intelligibility, fidelity and complexity. I'll go just bit further faster. Intelligibility is the parameter where we talk about the information generated out of any computational process, whether it is sufficiently able to transform the information without dependency on any input information, whether it is independent and conveying any message or not, whether the information which is generated is realistic, and whether the means in particular case of ATV, the orientation of the objects are okay or not. These three parameters we have taken for comparing calculating intelligibility. Then comes fidelity. Fidelity is the parameter of calculating adequacy and accuracy of the any computational process. So fidelity, it is comparison with the input text. Given an input text, whether that text has been interpreted out of the output of the system or not, that is first parameter. The meaning is conveying in the scene in this terms. and the number of objects, color, shape, size, background, placement of the objects are okay or not. This is the parameter we have calculated in fidelity. Complexity is the behavioral analysis of the system where we try to find whether that object, whether that scene is, how much difficult it is for a human to be evaluated. So these are the evaluation parameter. It is from 0 to 4. It is called Likert scale, and it is from 0 to 4, very bad to very good, or very good to very bad. So, okay, evaluation plan we have proceeded. And I want to focus over here because this is the core point where I want to talk about. This we have got this three-dimensional data. This means total number of evaluator we have got 130. Those were the volunteer evaluator. Total scene, as I have said, the 10 scene set we have evaluated. Each scene was mapped with 10 questions. So scene C is 10, question Q is 10. The response which is received is represented by small r. Rank value is 0 to 4 is represented by capital R. So one important thing which I want to note here, that the evaluator was allowed to move out of the evaluation survey after attempting at least 5 scenes. So first 5 scenes were attempted by all of the evaluators, but rest was incremental decreases. So number of responses for each scene has varied number of responses, but the questions were attempted by equal number of evaluators because each question has a particular 10 definite number of responses. So this is the data which I am going to represent here. This is the data where first 5 scene has been represented by 130 evaluators, and then 84, 77, 71, 70. In this way, the total sum of responses for a scene was 1020, represented by formula 1. And it is about particular question for all the question, because each scene has 10 questions, so it is multiplied by 10. So this is the data, this is the response value on which we have prepared our evaluation methodology. So in this way, this is the information proceeded. So the ranking value is R with question, the average of particular, this is talking about a particular single scene. So for CL scene, it is talking about the average of the response value. This is the standard deviation. This is for particular CL scene. When we are talking about all scenes, C1 to C10, so this is the average of the average value, because average of the CH scene and the average of the, this mouse is not working, I think. Okay, so this is the standard deviation of this. So we have derived this data. So the result I am going to represent here, the intelligibility of the quotient for particular, that's quotient scene C1 and quotient number Q1. The average of all the responses were 3.07, and for average of all the scene, it is coming down to 2.99. So in this way, we have structured, planned, analyzed, organized, built the data, and we have interpreted the information out of this. So this is the table for intelligibility and the corresponding graph. Similarly, the table for fidelity and corresponding graph. Result for complexity and similar graph. So the observation which we have found, that the first three question observations are based on the intelligibility. So if we have found that the all scenes are fairly intelligible for transforming the information. First observation 1, 2 and 3. Question observation 5 is about picture generates fairly accurate meaningful results. Observation 5 says is very accurate for generating number of objects. Similarly for 6, 7, 8 and 9 is somehow in between fairly accurate to very accurate information it is providing. Question number observation number 10 is talking about the complexity. It says that the all scenes was moderate complex for human to visualize. So this is the frequency distribution of user responses. So we can see that most of the responses are falling between 2 to 3, means fairly accurate, a fairly good response, and this is very accurate and very and this is good, and this is bad responses. So this is one more analysis of the data, so I can skip right now. And the evaluators information are like, it is provided that they were falling into the various social and educational background. They were varying with different number of ages. And the one more thing, important thing, that we have got this evaluation done by some NGOs where the students who are having the learning difficulties also attempted this evaluation process. So conclusion is that this is the only ATB system which is working for Indian languages, that is mainly for Hindi, morphological rich and free word order language, extendable to other Indian languages. And there are no much proven work already available, at least for ATB and for evaluation methodology. We had to start with this. And we have provided a short discussion on challenges and uses of the ATBs along with the evaluation process, result and analysis. The conclusion is that Preksha is tested out of 10,020 user responses, and we found that it is very intelligible, 3.02 out of 4 score, and fairly accurate, 2.91 out of 4 square. These are the references, and before thanking you, I would like to mention over here that the Preksha research work has been acknowledged by DST Apsara Award. It has been presented yesterday itself, and this was bestowed by President of India, Kovind, at the ceremony. And thank you for all your support, and thank you, Vishwa, for doing it. Thank you.
Thank you, Priyanka. And congratulations for the awards.